गुड मॉर्निंग. सो नाउ द फैक्ट, व्हाट आर द फैक्टर्स अफेक्टिंग इनटू द प्लाज्मा प्रोटीन बाइंडिंग. सो देयर इज अ डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ द फैक्टर्स आर देयर, लाइक फैक्टर्स रिलेटेड टू द ड्रग, फिजियोकेमिकल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ द ड्रग, कंसेंट्रेशन ऑफ द ड्रग, एफिनिटी ऑफ द ड्रग टू द पर्टिकुलर बाइंडिंग कंपोनेंट्स. नेक्स्ट इज व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट फैक्टर्स रिलेटिंग टू द प्रोटीन्स एंड अदर बाइंडिंग कंपोनेंट्स, physiochemical characteristics of the protein or binding agent, concentration of the protein and binding component, number of the binding site and binding agent. Next is drug interaction, competition between the drug and binding site, competition between drugs and normal body constituent, allostatic changes of the protein molecule. So these are the different factors and patient related factor, age, intersubject variation and disease state. So in the regular, you can say that classes, whenever we'll discuss about this different factor, but this is the overall, what are the different factors are there, which play an important role in the plasma protein binding. Now, the drug distribution or the binding. So we can say that the drug into the blood present into the either the bound form or the unbound form, already we have told. Like this is the plasma and drug, so if it is the bound form or it may be the present as the unbound form. Depending upon the drug affinity towards the protein, a proportion of the drug become bound to the plasma with the remainder drug is the unbound. So it is not like that 100% the drug it will be bound or unbound. Maybe a percent of the drug it will bind to the plasma and remaining percentage of the drug it will be present in as a free form. If the protein binding is reversible, then you can say that equilibrium exists between the bound and unbound state. So reversible, that means it will bind and after some time again it will be dissociated from the proteins. Now unbound fraction, already we have told, it is responsible for the exerting pharmacological effect, the unbound portion. Now for example, we can say that fraction of the anticoagulant fraction bound of the anticoagulant warfarin is the 97%. That means, what does it mean? The 97% of the warfarin after it will reach to the blood, after reaching to the blood, 97% of the warfarin it will bind to the plasma protein and remaining 3% is present into the unbound form and actually active and may excrete it. Now, protein binding influence the drug biological half-life because it will be present for a more number of the time. The bound portion may act as a reservoir of the depot from which the drug slowly diffuses into the unbound form. So, for example, anticoagulant drug warfarin we have seen 3% is free. So, when the 3% already it will be eliminated, again the remaining portion from the 97%, again some portion it will be unbound form. So, like this wise it will continue. Since the unbound form is the being metabolized or excreted from the body, the bound fraction will be released in order to maintain equilibrium as I have told now. Now, since albumin is the alkalotic, acidic and neutral drug will primarily bind to the albumin. So, as already we have told, a major portion of the drug, a different type of the drug, it will bind to the albumin. Now, if the albumin it will be saturated, then the drugs may bind to the another drug. The basic drugs mainly bind to the acidic alpha 1 acid glycoprotein. This is significant because you can say that in the various medical condition, the level of the albumin, alpha 1 glycoprotein, lipoprotein playing an important role. And these are the some references including the Brahmankar, Clinical Pharmacokinetics from Brahmankar, you can go through.